Chapter 8 time. Actually, today is chapter 9. Today is Thursday, January the 21st, 2021. And it is chapter 9 from the book of Genesis. The book of Genesis, which is in the Old Testament. Old Testament time. Book of Genesis, chapter 8, chapter 9. Chapter 9 is titled God's Covenant with Noah. And he reads, verse 1. Then God blessed Noah and his sons, saying to them, be fruitful and increase in number and fill the earth. The fear and dread of you will fall on all the beasts of the earth and on all the birds in the sky, on every creature that moves along the ground, and on all the fish in the sea. They are given into your hands. Everything that lives and moves about will be food for you. Just as I gave you the green plants, I now give you everything. But you must not eat meat that has its life still in it. And for your life, I will surely demand an account. I will demand an accounting from every animal and from each human being too. I will demand an accounting for the life of another human being. Whoever sheds human blood by humans shall their blood be shed. For in the image of God, God has made mankind. As for you, be fruitful and increase in number, multiply on the earth and increase upon it. Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him, I now establish my covenant with you and with your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, the birds, the livestock, and all the wild animals, all those that came out of the ark with you, every living creature on earth, I establish my covenant with you. Never again will all life be destroyed by the waters of the flood. Never again will there be a flood to destroy the earth. And God said, this is the sign of the covenant I am making between me and you and every living creature with you, a covenant for all generations to come. I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be the sign of the covenant between me and you and the earth. Wherever I bring clouds over the earth and the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will remember my covenant between me and you and all the living creatures of every kind. Never again will the waters become a flood to destroy all life. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and all living creatures of every kind on the earth. So God said to Noah, this is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and all the life on the earth. The sons of Noah. The sons of Noah who came out of the ark were Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Ham was the father of Canaan. These were the three sons of Noah. And from them came the people who were scattered over the whole earth. Noah, a man of the soil, proceeded to plant a vineyard. When he drank some of its wine, he became drunk and laid uncovered inside his tent. Ham, the father of Canaan, saw his father naked and told his two brothers outside. But Shem, Japheth took a garment and laid it across their shoulders. Then they walked in the backward and covered their father's naked body. Their faces were turned the other way so that they would not see it, their father's thinking. When Noah woke from his wine and found out what his youngest son had done to him, he said, "Cursed be Cain, the lowest of slaves. Will he be to his brothers?" He also said, "Praise be to the Lord, the God of Shem. May Canaan be the slave of Shem. May God extend Japheth's territory. May Japheth live in the tents of Shem. And may Canaan be the slave of Japheth." After the flood, Noah lived 350 years. Noah lived a total of 950 years, and then he died. This is chapter 9 from the book of Genesis, which is titled God's Covenant with Noah. It also talks about, through another title, the sons of Noah. Genesis, which leads to the scriptures known as the Holy Bible. Join me in next time's chapter reading from the book of Genesis, from the Holy Scriptures known as the Bible. Till then, adios!